anything, be like, you should go do it. He raced over to the nearby desk and hid underneath it. Okay, go ahead. Everything will be okay, right? All right. Hey, it'll be fun. Here we go. Yeah. We're on my way into the door, and the door opened much easier than I expected. And boom. Oh, look at that. It's a Monokuma station with Monokuma little hands. So, hold on. That means that there's a secondary room for Monokuma? There was no explosion, thankfully. The first impression was... Huh? This place is totally sci-fi. Yeah, I kind of was thinking the same thing. Ooh, where does that go? Some kind of hatch on the floor, but right now I'm more concerned about that weird device. What is this device? It looks like some kind of control panel. It's really over the top, though, like some kind of military installation or something. Yeah, it kind of looks like a mech cockpit, right? Ifumi'd probably freak out if he saw it. Cockpit. So the Monokuma room that has a control panel that looks like some kind of cockpit. Then could that mean... Okay. All right, let's start poking around or whatever, and I'm going to start pushing buttons. Hold on. You can't just do whatever or whatever, something like this, okay? It was too late. Hina was already jabbing away at the control panel. Huh? Did you hear that? Yeah, I think I came from the other room. You know, what did you push? I'm not totally sure, but I think it was that one. The button that says data center. Data center. Took a good look at the control panel. I saw a bunch of buttons, each with the name of a room next to it. Just like Hina said, there was one labeled data center. That must be the one she pushed, but the data center. That's right next door. Which just, that's where the strange news came from. I probably better go check it out. Yeah. Yes, please. I'm gonna kind of scared to go out of my mind right now. So I'll just cheer you on from over here. Right. Okay. So Monokuma. Is he? Did I just hear what I think I heard? And is that? Okay, so we found the cockpit. Hey! Ah! Rawr! Rawr! Give me all your donuts! Is that you, Hina?
What?
Aw, man! Busted! How did you know?
Say what?
Anyway, what is this? Some kind of remote control camera kind of setup? You don't even know what you're controlling?
Hello.
Well, I mean, I can't really see anything from here.
Found it!
I guess what I found? A self-destruct button. No, whatever you do, do not push it!
Too bad!
Aw, man! Are you seriously gonna push it? I guess that settles it. The room with the Monokuma drawing on it. It's a control panel for Monokuma. Which means... that the mastermind would have had to been in the room to orchestrate controlling. Even if you were to guide the conversations, problem with that is you couldn't account for all the variables. Everything was had a response to things, right? So nobody in our group is the killer. Or excuse me, the mastermind. Hey, Makoto, what the heck was that just now? Monokuma.
Huh?
What do you mean? What were you, what you were controlling just now? It was Monokuma.
Huh? Oh.
For real? Yep, it looks like that panel definitely controls Monokuma, which means Mastermind has been controlling Monokuma from this room. Yeah, they were definitely in here. Mastermind had been controlling from this room. And this control room is totally separate from the data center. In other words...
Hey.
They can only go from one or the other. Interesting. So it is only one person. Yoka Sirius was right. But if the mastermind's been controlling Monokuma from here, that means they've been inside the school this whole time, right? I guess that would have to be true. But if that is true... Okay, so people have already spoiled it, Junko, but like I had already theory crafted that she was the mastermind. But I'm trying to think... She was the one that walked up, instigated the fight. Huh. The only thing that's a little, like, shady about this is, well, how do you kill yourself and make it look real? In front of everybody else. My name is Celestia. You took away everyone I care about except Kyoko. And Mono, then Taka. Follow me, darling Celeste. Let's be first. Celeste had it coming. Taiko had it coming. I did love that you realized that, like, her accent is totally fake. That was a nice little twist. Was not expecting that. But I'm just trying to figure out, like, if Junko is the mastermind, because the first person to die would be the most likely of characters to, one, avoid suspicion from Kyoko, being the ultimate detective. Two, you could have a little bit of fun messing with everyone there, and then also going in and having the rest of the show, if you will, controlling Monokuma. But the thing that I'm trying to figure out is early on, when Monokuma came out, was that pre-programmed or was that based on responses with pre-programmed, like, kind of like Alexa, right? Alexa! No, not now, Alexa. Sorry. Alexa, off. Insert name, have response. Yeah. Also, the fact that Sakura died was, however, Sakura, like a boss, breaking the door down and then having Monokuma get pissed was choice. It's an A, morning. Then the mastermind, Monokuma's puppeteer, really is the 16th student. But I'm trying to remember. Anytime that Monokuma showed up in the couple of hours early on, Junko wasn't in the area. The only time that happened was twice. One was a pre-recorded, and then he showed up, Monokuma showed up, but the conversation was guided initially by Junko, and then the second interaction with Junko was totally guided by Junko, and she ended up dying, right? But then everything else had been very similar to, like, what you would do with insert name that has Google. So if I say, how did you do that? Why did you do that? Voice command would fire back a pre-programmed response. And I mean, shit, if you could have a walking, talking teddy bear that is, like, super advanced, you can program voice-activated things, right? I mean, no, it can't be. There's no way, right? What's wrong, Makoto? I don't like that face you're making. Oh, no, it's nothing. Oh, okay. What about you? Is everything okay? Oh, well, it's just, this is where the mastermind's been hiding, right? Who knows if they set up traps or something? I can't say it isn't possible, but I really hope it's not true. You want to leave soon? Still, like, lots of other places to check out. Yeah, good point. I, not a teddy bear, I am Monokuma. I'm about to, like, rip out Monokuma's stuffing here. We can't waste all our time standing around here. Okay, you want to get going? Yeah. Okay, hold on. We are not leaving just yet. What's wrong, Makoto? Let's hurry up and get out of here. Okay. You gotta be shitting me, man. soon as the door to the data center was closed, I heard a strange sound. What was that? The door, it just locked on its own. What? Nani? My hand shot out to grab the doorknob. You're right, it's locked, but why? Of course it's locked, because the data center is now restricted. Monokuma.
Just a second.
Hey, no fair, you can't just go around restricting whatever you feel.
Hey.
It's for your benefit. Because if that room stays open, I won't be able to move around. Imagine how depressed everyone would get if the school mascot just up and stopped moving. But that room?
Yep.
As you may have guessed, that's where my controls are. So, right now you're being operated by someone in that room.
Yes, indeed.
Correctamundo.
You're a liar.
But that doesn't make any sense. We were just in there and we didn't see anyone. Ina, my sweet, 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 lovely little child. There was a hatch on the ground that I was trying to actually open up, but you really desperately wanted to leave. Like, why? Okay. No, you didn't, did you? Are you sure you were as thorough as you could have been? I was trying! Oh, God. Did you happen to check a certain suspicious hatch? Yes. No, no way. The hatch on the floor? Too bad. That was your one big chance and you blew it. No, I didn't. No, I didn't. That was the first thing I checked. And right before Hina was like, we gotta leave. That's the last thing I checked. And in both situations, the game's like, nope. Man, if I've ever saw the Dez, I'd probably smack him at least once. Give me a second. I'm gonna go blow my nose and be right back. Damn it! It's not a fake door. It was real. It was the hatch. And it had the headmaster, aka the mastermind, just chilling out in there.
Too bad.
Of course, that hatch can't be opened from the outside anyway, so whatever. Don't we have, like, some chemicals that we could use? Boy. If I told Hina, Hina, I want you to wait here. Or go get somebody. Oh, crap. Sorry, wrong button. Sorry. I would lather the ground like acid. Lather the chair, the controls, just destroy it all. And be like, well, oopsie. Sorry. Now then, this room is officially restricted, so no more investigation.
Yes, hey, morning.
And I'll be relying on you guys to tell the others. Peace!
I will show you no peace. I will show you no mercy. I will find you. I will pull your stuffing out, Monokuma.
He's gone, but...
Is
he telling the truth? The mastermind was hiding in there the whole time? In fact, if you think about when we got locked out, the control room, Crucifer for sure. Huh? I mean, what is he gonna do? Kill me again? Come on, stuffing, spring it! Because as far as I can tell, that's the control panel for Monokuma, right? If he can't do anything and he can't leave, then you rip the door down, like you unscrew the hinges, remove the door, and you wait. Like, we can wait all day, but if that's not like a bunker with supplies, we don't know. But if it's just like a little hatch, man. Checkmate, buddy. Checkmate. Then, when I said we should leave, well, that hatch couldn't be open from the outside anyway, right? Well, as far as you know, he didn't even let me check. So it's not your fault.
Sorry.
Okay. Anyway, we don't have to let it get to us, all right? We just have to stay positive and make the most of the time we have left. Right. One thing I'm good at, it's keeping my body moving.
Okay.
I'm gonna go around and tell everyone what we found here. Nice! You got me all motivated again.
You got it!
Okay, I'm out. See ya. He need to talk off at full sprint. I have to do what I can too. Aha! It's the only way to forward. Alright. Any other spot on this? Ooh. Headmaster room. And what did you know it? Oh, got me. This is the headmaster's room. I've heard an awful lot about it, but this will be my first time seeing it for myself. Makoto, it's you. Oh, Nogami. Well, you came to the right place this time. You'd like to see something interesting. What do you mean? Take a look at this. It's on top of that pathetically ostentatious desk. It's even registered. Contains profiles for all of us and Mukuro.
So in other words...
Apparently Class 78 refers to us. Wait, when we found Mukuro's file in Kyoka's room...
I see.
That's right, it also mentioned Class 78. This must be where Kyoko got that page. And since the rest of our profiles are listed in there along with hers...
In other words...
There can be no doubt. Mukuro was a student here at Hope's Peak Academy, just like the rest of us. That must be how Kyoko learned about it. But it seems that Kyoko was in a hurry. What do you mean? Talk about when she stole it. The uneven tearing, the way the paper had been crumpled, she must have been in a hurry. Well, I mean, since she snuck in to get to it, I'm sure she wanted to get it as fast as possible. But what's your point? She was in so much of a hurry that she only got the first page. Correct. Kyoko's profile actually contains two pages.
So, in other words...
When it comes to this profile, there was more information. What kind? Why do you ask me to explain every little thing you can read, can't you? It seems to be some of the sort of detailed report put together by the headmaster himself. I don't know what kind of a man he was, but I'm glad he left us such an interesting clue. I was half listening to Byakuya as I skimmed through the report. Mukuro reappeared suddenly in the background and an entity floats... Close, but just out of reach? I'm sorry, what? And in the background, an entity floats. Close, but just out of reach. The entity known as the Ultimate Despair. Right now, I can't be sure if this is a single person or some kind of group. Whatever it is, Mukuro definitely has some sort of connection to it. I have a bad feeling about all this. I need to push forward with my research into the Ultimate Despair. And I need to pay attention to Mukuro's behavior, too. This is just my gut feeling, but I think she's dangerous. Despite the countless battles she must have gone through as a member of Thinner. When she entered Hope's Peak Academy, she didn't display any signs of battle wounds or scars. That fact alone proves her tremendous skill in battle. Okay, so there's a good chance that... Mukuro... went on a killing spree, and then... they isolated her. Quietly kept it out of the public, but didn't clean any of the rooms because I don't know why. Maybe Junko realizing her opportunity and realizing that Ultimate Despair is in fact insanely fun because maybe she went crazy in the carnage, right? Just batshit crazy. Decided to have a plan of seizing control of the school and the chaos. What would she have done with the rest of the other classmates unless they were all removed and then she brought the ultimates back, killing the headmaster, pretending to be him? To bait people in? Maybe? But where would she get the funding to retrofit the school, though? as well as the manpower. Naturally, I want to believe in her. She's one of my students, after all. But if I decide she's a danger to the other students, I will be forced to take all reasonable measures. Mukuro, it's part of the ultimate despair. I don't think there can be any doubt about it. But wouldn't that mean Mukuro and the Mastermind were allies? So why? Why would they kill Mukuro? Plus, even the Headmaster seemed to be afraid of what Mukuro was capable of. They would have had to take her completely by surprise to kill her like that. Or maybe it means the Mastermind is even stronger than Mukuro was?
What?
What's wrong, Makoto? Huh?
That's fine.
You seem to be lost in thought, but I should probably point out one other thing. There's another important bit of information within the file that you should note. What is it? Did you notice a picture in there? A picture of a girl perhaps you've never seen before. A girl who seems to be included as part of our class. That should be enough for you to figure out who the girl is. It's probably the photo, her ID photo for Mukuro. And further information about that girl is included in the file. 5 foot, 7 inches, 97 pounds, and even lists her vitals as 31, 22, 33, or 32. I'm sorry, what? Wow, I didn't. Is that normal in Japan where, like, they get the bust size, the hip size, and... Yes, those are vitals indeed, yes. Well, what do you think? What do... You're asking me, like, if she has a nice body?
Stop talking.
You hopeless idiot. What I'm trying to tell you is maybe you'll want to keep that in mind for later. Maybe you'll want your way back to the... Maybe you'll make your way back to the corpse, and maybe you'll think, ooh, could that mean... Wait, is he trying to say... Is Togami a necrophiliac? I mean, look, dude, like... I mean, I'm gonna judge the hell out of you because that's sick and disgusting, but... kind of a bad time to be telling me this, right? Like... I can't... Junko, she has red press-on nails. Wait, is he trying to say... There's a chance the body isn't actually Mukuro. Is that what he's saying? Personally, what I'm thinking seems all but impossible. But it wouldn't hurt to confirm, right?
It's all clear now.
That's all I was trying to say, but... What you do with that information is your business. See, here's the thing. I'm thinking that... Junko, in an attempt to make it as confusing as possible, actually put press-on nails on Mukuro. I still think that is Mukuro. It just means that I have to touch a dead body, get, like, measurements, be like, all right, I think, well, it's only been a couple of days. There's a good chance she hasn't put, like, on any weight, right? As in, like, stressed eat, which I could still see a person doing, right, naturally. But... Check this, all right, looks like, I mean, half her boob might be wiped away. Like, again, bomb to the face, chat. Bits and pieces could get, like, chucked away. Oh my god, this game's getting weird. All right, I'm sorry. Okay. I'm back to being errand boy, right.
Nice. We got the vitals.
Oh, and one last thing. No, I'm thinking burn me because loss of bust size due to dehydration. I don't think that's how that works, but yeah. Bit of advice from me to you, so I suggest you pay attention. Oh, for me. You seem to be getting along with Gyoko quite well. It's not that we're getting along, it's just done a lot to help me. Well, don't put too much faith in her. Huh?
In other words,
the cost of that faith might be more than you can afford. What are you saying? Just what I think. Call it a hunch. My hunches tend to be proven right. The advice is free this time. Take it or don't, as you will. I'll keep that in mind, thanks. Wait, are you saying... Togami slowly starting not become an asshole? Is his puckered clenches, butt cheeks slowly unclenching and... He's slowly, somewhat coming into his own as a natural human with emotions and things called empathy and apathy and sympathy. He's more He's got all the P's, if you will.
Wait for the second. We got people who are went extra disgusting with Junko.
Extra? How much more? You know what? Actually, never mind. It's anime. It can get a lot more extra. And you are right. Junko did actually try to get me killed and had no real indication. It was a hunch that Alter Ego would save me. A hunch. Yeah, I think there's like a 50-50 that, you know, what we thought was destroyed actually infected the systems of Monokuma's computers as a virus and was slowly waiting for its opportunity to attack. Find or save somebody. Just a hunch, though. The bookshelf seems really well made, and it's filled with files and thick books. Wait, hang on. Kit, does that mean that... Because we saw the alternate ending, right? Which...
Poor Hina.
Does that mean that Alter Ego would have stayed quiet and let her get squishy-squish?
Second game, extra disgusting parts for you, but let's just say it gets weirder. Oh, Case. I appreciate that, brother. We'll get to... I've already bought Danganronpa 2. Already bought Ultra Despair Girls and Danganronpa 3.
And we also, I bought Phoenix Wright game, the first three games for PC. So, on top of Wasteland 2 beating, Borderlands 3, Trials of Mana on Friday, we're going to have a lot of anime going on here. It's going to be somewhat of like a JRPG / adventure visual novel anime channel for a little while, so sorry in advance. We don't know because the studio was all Makoto's head. Would you think Makoto would, in his mind, be like, since Alter Ego saved me, I will revise that action and assume that she was saved. I just kind of think she would like abandon me though. Down the road, we will play Doki Doki Literature Club. Inky swear promise. I hear that game is also just as weird. I have no idea why. I remember watching Aaron and Dan play on Game Grumps, but I only watched the first 15 minutes of that game, and it looked like a dating sim game. And I still really don't know why people are like, oh my god, you have to, okay. Kinda isn't, okay. Or generally know the ending of the second Danganronpa game. There are trophies and even a shield in the display case. Okay. It still hasn't been swelled. No, it hasn't been swelled for me. No. Guys, 3 or 4 years ago, I played Final Fantasy VII for the very first time. Luckily, those that were in chat did not spoil the major plot points of that game. And, I only knew two things about that game. One, that there's a ton of fanboys. And two, with enough hair gel, anything can stick up. Even in the headmaster's room, there's a monitor. See, Aerith died. Aerith lives. Yeah, so you just got to get the right version. That's the thing. Yeah, you just got to get the right version. Yeah. Right version. Yeah. Makes a whole difference. Actually, for the remake, I'll be very curious to see what they do with that. Because from what I'm hearing, they're making some sweeping changes. So, yeah. Which, one last pause. Sorry. it depends on, like, which region you play, Super. Either she's